Hello, beautiful people. We are back and brunetter than ever. To be honest, I'm kind of sad about it, but I'll let you guys know all about those details in today's video. I'm also going to just update you on everything going on. I'm going to share with you life after Monet. And also, I'm going to answer some of the questions that I got from you guys on my Instagram, all about my hair, just some random questions that you guys wanted to know about, and I figured I'd put it into this video. So, let's go ahead and jump right in. Back in June of 2020, I, like many of us, were finally hitting that extreme point of cabin fever. Yeah, June, y'all remember? Yes. I went ahead and decided to go blonde. But this time was different from a lot of the other times that I went blonde because I never fully committed and I didn't focus on the healthy way to do it. Usually didn't choose the right people to do it for me, usually did it myself and really screwed my hair up. So this time I was focused on doing blonde, fully committing and doing it in a way that wouldn't damage my curls. And I'm happy to say that I really feel like I achieved that. With the help of my hairstylist, my aunt, she did an incredible job. I have a ton of videos, if you haven't already checked them out on my channel, that explain my whole process. I'm gonna go ahead and link my first curly hair journey video for you guys so you can see where I came from before that and why this was such a big deal for me when I did go blonde. And then during this past summer, I did another update for my curly hair journey. So if you haven't watched that, I'll also link that up here. So between June and October, I had lightened my hair a total of 3 times. It was mainly for maintenance purposes, really just to, you know, root touch up. I think only 1 time did I actually lighten more strands in my hair. I think I'll put up some pictures just for you guys to see so you can see the difference. I did go a bit lighter after the second session, and then the third session was more or less just a touch up back in October. After October, I took a break. You know, you don't really have to dye your hair as much and touch up as much in the winter time as you do in the summer. So I just took a little chill pill, and I was hoping that the blonde would turn into more of a balayage as my hair would grow out. And I was really excited to be able to do that. But as you know, I started using Monat hair products. Have a whole video on that as well in detail about my whole experience. For those of you that have watched it, you know that my hair fell out after using the products. So a lot of my progress that I had made with my curly hair journey was set back, and it was pretty devastating. Once I discovered my hair was falling out from Monet, I immediately stopped using the products, and I decided just not to do anything to my hair because I was, as you could imagine, kind of traumatized. I continued that up until March, and I got to the point, and if you've been blonde, you know this point, where it's like you cannot hide from your roots. Like, you have to do something. You either have to, you know, do a root touch up, you have to change the hair color in some way, because otherwise you're just stripes. You know what I'm saying? So I got to that point and I was like, all right, I have to make a decision. And it was so hard to decide because I really love the blonde. I didn't feel like it damaged my hair that much. Like, I felt like, yes, after a session, my curls would be a little weak, but then they would bounce back the next week and I'd be fine. So I was confident that I found a safe way to do blonde with my curls. But at the same time, I had to start thinking long-term because I was like, can I sustain this maintenance? There's something big that I've been planning a little bit later this year that I cannot wait to share with you. I've left you one clue already in the camping vlog video, but I'm gonna leave you clue number 2 in this video. And the main reason why I decided to go dark was because maintaining the blonde in my new situation will not be sustainable. So that is your clue number 2, and that's all I'm gonna say. That's why I was really sad about it, because I was like, I really enjoyed doing the blonde hair. This is the first time in my life that I'm dyeing my hair and I'm not 100% happy with my choice, which is weird, but it's for the greater good. I know that I will thank myself later. And also, being brunette has lots of perks too. Definitely, it's easier to maintain because obviously it's closer to my natural hair color, so I really don't have to do much of anything. When I have darker hair, I feel like it's easier to make my hair seem more moisturized and healthy versus when it's blonde because I do feel like the lighter color the hair, the more frizzy it looks, the more dry it looks. So yeah, I'm happy with it. I think it's beautiful. I like it. I feel confident with it. I feel like my aunt did a phenomenal job. Do you know your girl was this close to doing a box dye because that's just how I am. I'm just about like, I want to change my hair. Let's do it now. I can do it myself. But my aunt convinced me. She was like, don't do that. Let me do your hair color. What kind of look do you want? So I looked on Pinterest. I found this picture. I was like, I want my hair to look like this. And then you can do my hair. She's like, I'll make it look just like that. Took her an hour. Bam. This lighting, this studio lighting is really bad at showcasing the actual color of the hair. But in the light, it looks identical. I'm so, so happy with how it turned out. And I'm going to be rocking it for quite some time until I get bored with it. And you guys will see me talking on here again, telling you. I decided to do something else. So what products am I using now? I have been using since January Way hair care products. I was able to partner with them exclusively, which was so incredibly exciting. It was one of the biggest deals I had at the time. And I fell in love with their products. Like I really, really did. I've been using it since January and I really love them. I use the shampoo. They have a deep conditioner. They have their curl cream, which is bomb, which is what I use to style my curls today and what I usually have been using. I have the video of me explaining to you in detail of everything that I use on Way's YouTube channel. I was able to showcase the new curl cream that they introduced and be able to share with you guys how to use it. So go ahead and check that video out if you want to see my current curly hair routine because that's exactly what I did today. That's what I've been doing. I've really been loving it. Other than the Way products that I use for the shampoo and the conditioner, I also use the deep conditioning mask that I mentioned in this video. I have so many videos to reference. This is nice. That's all that I'm pretty much using on my hair. Immediately after I stopped using Monat, my hair stopped falling out. That's why I made the video because I realized this was the products. There's just no way around it. Now, just a little bit of tea. I'm just gonna give you a little bit because I don't wanna go crazy. I did not expect after posting that video the amount of backlash I would get. Like I knew that I was gonna get some backlash, but I didn't think that it was gonna be to that extent. I got hate messages, people bullying me, like it was crazy. Don't feel bad for me though, because it was hilarious, in my opinion. It was so cult-like, you know? Like these people were after my life because I released this video explaining my personal experience with it. And I can't speak for all of the Monet, Monat representatives, I know, but there were so many of them that came from my blood. I was like, whoa. This is legit. It's just so crazy how intense it got. I think overall, it just made me more upset after I made the video when I saw not necessarily the negative remarks, but the amount of people that had gone through the same thing that I had gone through, but were in denial because of the pressure and the constant bullying that they received from their own friends and family. They break you down. And I feel like there's so many people that are being broken down to try Monat just because several people are approaching them, pushing it. You know, if the product is good, why do you have to push so hard? That is my question. No is a complete sentence. If someone cannot respect when you say no and leave you alone after that, there's something wrong. That's all that I'll do today because I could go on and talk about it. Maybe I'll do a video in the future because it got so much attention and I think it's something that should be talked more about. So that is that. I'm gonna go ahead now and answer some of the questions that I had you guys ask me on Instagram, the little poll question thing that you guys had to ask me questions about my hair. So I'm gonna go ahead and answer them. First question I have is, what hair straightener tool do you use? So the hair straightener tool that I use currently is the TYMO hair straightener. It works pretty good. I really like it. I will go between that one and then I'll also use one called LUV Love. I have it linked in my Amazon store, so I'll put that in the description box for you guys to check out. That one really gets me super sleek straight hair. I'm gonna have to do an updated straighten routine for you guys because I get a lot of questions on how I get it really super sleek. That tool is my favorite. Coming soon. Best moisturizer for curly, frizzy prone hair, East Coast. I'm on the East Coast, so I'm right there with you. I'm constantly trying to find new ways to help control the frizz, especially with the humidity. Like, it's insane. I don't think that I can say that I found the foolproof solution yet, But I do think that what helps me out is the combination I've been using, the Whey Curl Cream, and then also I think what most helps seal from the humidity is a gel. So I use the Miss Jessie's Jelly Soft Curls, and that I feel like the more I use of that, it really holds in the curl and kind of helps get rid of that frizz. I have some frizz right now going on, but I didn't put a lot of jelly. That Miss Jessie's curl gel is not cheap, so I try not to use too much of it. I just kind of scrunch it a little bit at the ends, but it definitely helps hold the curl. When I'm feeling a little bit more like this, I will go ahead and put it all over my hair, and then it really helps keep the curls intact. Can you take your hair off and give it to me? Thanks. You got it. Do you ever see a curly girl whose curls could be so much better and offer advice? I never give unsolicited advice because I don't like unsolicited advice, and I just don't think that it's fair. If it was someone, I think it just depends on the situation. Like if I was close to them, then obviously, yes, I would help them even if they didn't ask me. But if it's like a stranger, I would never tell them that they need help with their hair. I would just, you know, let them do what they do. Would I ever tell them their hair looks good when it wasn't? Absolutely not. But you know, we keep it moving. How often do you get a trim? So I just got a trim when I dyed my hair, which was in March. I'm not a big person on making sure I get my trims in. A test that I learned was you can tell when you definitely need to trim your ends when you put oil on the bottom. Like I put my hair in like ponytails, like braids rather, and I'll put oil at the bottom of them. And if the oil doesn't absorb into the hair, it's dead, chop it off. I don't chop my hair anymore because I get scissor happy. I just, when I stopped doing that, my hair actually grew. Like, who would have known? Wow. How do you keep curls intact during a workout? Great question. So for me, I go ahead and I put my hair up in a waterfall ponytail with my silk scrunchie. So I put it up like this and I'm good. And usually, sometimes I have to make it a little tighter so that if I'm doing a really intense workout that it stays in place, but usually I have no problem and that's how I keep my curls intact. How do you refresh your curls in between wash days? So my mist bottle is my best friend. I have it linked in my Amazon store. It is just a nice little bottle that helps refresh my curls. The water reactivates the product already in my hair that's dried and then I'm all good to go. The final question, what that hair do? That is Yannick. He sent me that question because anytime I do questionnaires on my Instagram, my husband Yannick will go in there and ask me what that thing do. Yes. So this time, because it was all about my hair, he says, what that hair do? In answer to his question, the hair does this. I think that was a good question to end on. Thank you, Yannick. That is it for today's video. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video of me rambling and talking. I hope that it was helpful to you. Again, I'm going to make sure I have everything linked in the description box as much as I possibly can so you guys have all the information you need. If I missed anything, please let me know in the comment section below. More curly content to come, definitely in the future, but a lot more vlogs because I'm seeing that you guys really like the vlogs. So we're gonna keep on going with the vlog. So stay tuned. In a lot of my vlogs, I will be doing curly hair routines, makeup routines, all things health, beauty, and adventure all together in one. So just stay tuned. Also, thank you for 5K. We got 5,000 subscribers here on YouTube. Our baby channel is growing. We're growing bigger and bigger. This is so exciting. Thank you guys for 5K. I appreciate you so much for supporting me. I appreciate each and every one of you that have subscribed and those that have been with me from the very beginning. I know that you're here. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. If you have not already, please make sure you are subscribed. Don't forget to like this video and to comment below. Thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Oh, 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 o